know what it is. It's your boy Tunchi, and this is YBE TV. You know what I'm saying? Hey, look, today I want to talk to you about one of the biggest things that hurt people that I can think of, and that would be tradition. Most people pass down the most dumbest fucking traditions, or most people pay attention to the traditions that's passed down to them, and they never look at the consequences of that tradition. Like, prime example, drugs, gangs, and jail. One of the biggest things that's passed down from generation to generation that I hear all the time in the streets is, man, my uncle, my brothers, my cousins was in the game, so you know what I'm saying? You feel me? Like, but you're not paying attention to your uncle in the joint for the rest of his fucking life. Your brother is in jail for the rest of his fucking life. Your cousin, two of your cousins got killed. They fucking dead. You never gonna see them again. And your daddy be sitting outside of Arby's and shit begging for change. Like, come on, let's be realistic, man. On some real shit. So, like, look at the fucking tradition. See, me personally, the whole gang shit, I'm not passing it down, because the one thing that I can't do that I figured out finally that I could honestly say out loud is, I'll be damned if I call another man king again in my motherfucking life. I'm a grown-ass man referring to another man as king. Another man with two arms, two legs, a dick, and some balls just like me. I'll be goddamn if I'm going to refer to another man as king. That's not going to happen, and I'm not going to do it. So I'm not in no gang. If you ask me what I am, I'm YBE. That's my gang. Anything else, I'm not it. I'm not associated, affiliated. I'm not a gangbanger. I'm done. Like, that's it. No, thank you. Moving on to the next thing that is a tradition that I hate. I hate the fact that people pay attention to everything else in this world, but they eating habits. I watched grandmama's auntie be obese, overweight. People get their feet cut off. In my family, diabetes has ran rampant in my family. Ridiculously high rates of diabetes in my family. The thing is that a lot of the people got diabetes and they changed their diet after they got it. A lot of them didn't start off with a good diet, or most likely wouldn't have gotten it. I didn't have to pass that tradition down. You know why? Because I changed my eating style. Prime example. Avocado, kale, it's got avocado, kale, spinach, and bananas, and almond milk. No, cashew milk. All smoothie, right? That's part of my breakfast. I had, this one is gone. It was a fruit salad in there. Had watermelon, cantaloupe, fruit salad. This right here is a tea that I bought from the farmer's market. It's not rhubarb tea, but it's a tea, and it's really good for blood pressure. I forget the name of the tea. I'm going to try to write it in the description when I figure it out. This right here is no meat. If you can see this, like, okay. Green beans, organic pieces of a potato, red potato. And this right here is fake chicken. This is part of my lunch on the truck. I just heat it up, rocking and rolling. And last but not least, this is another snack that I got. Mango salad. It's got little mango pieces. It's got some avocado, some little walnuts, some sesame, as you see. And you see, this is this got Swiss chard in it, spinach, and kale. So, like, at the end of the day, I'm breaking that cycle. And I'm not passing down the tradition of diabetes no more. So it's gonna stop. So what I would say is, and another, this is the last one before I go. It's the last one. Teenage pregnancy. I swear to God, I've heard so many women telling their kids, basically implanting in their mind how old they was when they had them and how things turned out to be okay. Listen, family, it's not okay. Baby, listen. I ain't got nothing against public assistance, because when I was growing up, we had public assistance growing up. But the thing is, it's not fun. I know damn well don't nobody like the fact that people come in your house, searching your house, seeing who in your house, telling you what to do, when you could do it, telling you all these different things that you got to do and you got to be, places you got to go, things you got to do just so you could continue to get this. So you could be able to feed your family and take care of your family. What I will say is this. It's time to break that cycle and quit telling your kids that, well, I made it this, this, and this. Quit saying it like it's a fucking tradition for me to be pregnant. I got pregnant at 14 years old, and I handled my business and this, this, and this. No, tell them the devastation that your ass went through being 14, because I can't talk shit. I had my first kid. I knocked up my kid's mother at 16 years old. At 17 years old, that baby was spit out. So you might as well say, I say 16 years old, I popped my first baby. 16 years old. But I'll be damned if I want my kids to be 16 years. I tell them about the devastation, how my life ended right then and there, being 16 years old. So only thing I'm going to say is, even when it comes to religion and everything else, man, do not pass down these ridiculous traditions. Go out and find your own way and look to, at the consequences to these traditions. Because some of these religions have you going out thinking that you should be peaceful and you should have look into a higher power to solve all your problems when you got two arms and two legs and a goddamn brain, and you should be able to solve something for yourself. So I'm not calling out no one religion. I'm not calling out any religion. Only thing I'm saying is find your own way. It's just like for one religion that I really don't like, and I'm not gonna pick on the bigger religions, is Scientology. I'm not a fan of it because they don't like to use the medical industry, which I'm kind of against somewhat, but in one of the ways I'm not against it. I am against it. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people die from it. They're not going to see doctors and shit like that when they need to. You feel me? So with that being said, man, like, I'm not a fan of Scientology. And if somebody is passing that down, just look at the consequences to that shit. That's all I'm saying. That's all I got to say. You already know what it is. It's your boy, Tunchi. And if you don't want to end up in a box, think outside of it. Make your own traditions. YBE.
Drug dealing and killing is going on in my town. It don't take a killer to kill or a driller to drill. See, just being yourself is the definition of real.